my brother, Patrick Carpentier, is joining us now. Let's go back to Talladega. Your side of the story. What happened?
Yeah, it was just a tough day. You know, when you don't make the race, don't qualify, everybody's temper goes up a little bit. And it did on that day, but honestly, we have been struggling for three, four races. We missed Bristol, and it seems like we're struggling more than before. So I can agree with the team. There was a decision that had to be made, and we sat down after that and talked to each other and reached an agreement. And I thought it was better for both of us to move forward to split. So same for them. So it's a shame. I got an early vacation this year, but it's a shame. But they still gave me a heck of an opportunity this year.
When the decision was made to release you, who actually made that decision?
Yeah, it was. I'm not sure who made it. I think it was Tom Redden on the team or the board. I wasn't there to make the final decision, and we had a few talks over the phone. I talked with Foster also, as well as Montreal, and we all decided that it would be best. You know, they need to try something. They need to get that car number 10 a little bit more up to speed there. So they're gonna try different things, and I agreed with it. So for me, it was something that we just talked, and we decided to stop it there and see what happened. So that's all we did. But it was you could see it coming. I mean, the last month we were trying really hard and we couldn't pick it up. And so it's all good. And I mean, for them, the Gillette family, if they wouldn't have given me the opportunity this year, I don't think I would have had one. So I will always be thankful with them. And we left on good terms. I mean, they called me this morning and stuff like that. So it's pretty good.
Ray Evernham has been on the record as saying he was against the decision to release you. What was his reaction, at least to you?
Ray's always been, and that's what I want to say, because I know there was a lot of blogs and stuff on the internet that people were like, oh, Ray didn't, but Ray Evernham's always, for me, everything he said he would do, he's always done. For me, Ray Evernham is one of the most straightforward guys I've ever seen. And they always told me, you know, in my even in my agreement and stuff, I always knew that if the sponsor or somebody would want a change in the car, that they were going to do it. And I remember the first press conference we did in Montreal when we did it with the Montreal Canadiens. I said, I'm going to race until they want me to. And when they don't want me to, then it's going to stop right there. If a sponsor doesn't want to or whatever it is. And that's where it came down to. So it's basically a business. But Ray Evernham, I think he's a class act.
Bottom line, what have you learned this year?
I learned a lot. Let me tell you, I learned that racing Spring Cup Series is tough. I mean, these guys are good. They know their cars. They run the cars well. And a lot of people say, you know, it's just ovals. You just turn left. Or you don't just turn left. You turn right also. And it's a very tough business. But you know what? I had so much fun, and I loved it.
What's next for you? Will we see you back in the Spring Cup Series, or at least in Nationwide Series?